lovely sort of just great relationship, nasty. I have a bunch of really wonderful songs. But then you ended up with a stable relationship and you don't have anything to write about. So she says to me, actually, she said to me the other day, she says, well, I'll find something to piss you off. I said, nah, it's okay. I think I'll leave it alone. So I turned to basically writing things that, you know, I find news columns or something, and something that grabs me and I write about. In this particular piece, there was a young girl, you probably know the story, about 5 or 6 years ago now. She was 7 years old. She was going to fly across the United States by herself. Well, solo, but she was going to have somebody with her, obviously. And she was seven. And at the time, the FAA and everybody else was like, God, how can you let this kid do this? And they managed to do this thing. And of course, the second day of her journey, she's in Wyoming and crashes the plane and kills everybody. But the day before she died, she gave an interview and she talked about how she loved flying and so on. And one of the lines she says, I'm going to fly till I die. And the next morning, she crashed in a muddy field in Wyoming. And it grabbed me so much just reading the stories about her and watching her and just thinking, God, this is amazing. A seven-year-old kid, I hardly rode a bicycle when I was seven, let alone fly a plane. And I just thought it was an amazing thing. And it just, I sat, after she died, I was just so upset about it. I sat within about a half an hour and wrote this song. And I tailored it after a sort of a kid's folk song. So that's basically how this works. And it's called Fly Away Home. Mud-ridden sky. St. Pete ignores me as I walk through the door. My broken wings dangle and drag across the floor. Thank you.